Stoked to be involved with the Sunday Time Gin Lifestyle Awards. Did I say that right? Mainly because it's going to expose me to a lot of gins that I didn't even know existed. And of course, meet people in the industry who can grow my knowledge. Already, like the bearded gin guy has taught me things about gin that I didn't know, you know? I thought gin was gin. Turns out it's not.
Well, I thought that it would have like a bit of a peak last year when I tasted 76 gin. But this year we're on 110, so obviously it's still growing. And that is very inspiring.
Today has opened my eyes to so many different kinds of gin and also tasting gins as naked as possible. I think I've been masking my gin tasting with so many different things and beautiful condiments that I was not tasting the gin in its true essence.
We still have to create a gin culture in South Africa. It's not here yet, but I think that the more people are exposed to the different crafts, they definitely are getting an experience of gin, and therefore we are creating a culture.
I think people are opening up to it and playing with it more. What this does is it breeds another culture in terms of people are moving past the gin and tonic and experimenting with stuff like martinis, right? And stuff a little bit stronger that'll bring up the gin more than the actual tonic. So it becomes a little bit more of a sipper drink than just like a smashing drink.